As we talked about in previous videos, improving the performance of your web pages can have many positive impacts such as increased conversions, decreased bounce rates, and even positive impacts on your bottom line. Many times, optimizing the images on your site can be a quick win for you when you start trying to improve your site's performance. And so today, I'm going to talk about a new image format called WebP that will help you get started and optimize your images. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. I spent 20 years working in the enterprise IT shop, and during that time, my most rewarding role was a lead programmer on a web development team. I loved being able to help other developers grow. That's the primary reason I started my Guiding Digital business and YouTube channel. I want to come alongside web developers, marketers, and small business owners and help you grow in your web development and digital marketing skills. So if this interests you, subscribe below to stay informed about future content. In today's video, I'm going to define what WebP images are, go over the benefits of using WebP images, and then give you practical advice on how to implement WebP images. So let's get to it. WebP is a new format that was developed by Google in 2010. WebP provides improved lossless and lossy compression for images. And so the major benefit to using WebP images is their reduced size. According to Google, on average, WebP images are 30% smaller in size compared to PNGs and JPEGs. If you look at the total payload of most web pages, images on most sites account for over half of that payload. So by using WebP images and reducing your images by 30%, you can make a noticeable impact on your site's performance metrics. However, there are a few things you should keep in mind before converting all of your images to WebP. The first thing you need to be aware of is related to cross-browser support. If we go to the site Can I Use, which shows which browsers support certain features, we see that WebP has a high rate of browser support. Globally, about 78% of users are going to be using a browser that supports WebP, so that's pretty good. However, there are a couple noticeable holdouts. The first is i11, which I hesitated in calling noticeable. i11 usage has dropped dramatically over the last 5 years, but it does have a foothold in some enterprises still. i11 seems to be on its way out, probably will never get WebP support. The more significant holdout, in my opinion, is Safari. Both desktop and mobile Safari browsers currently do not support WebP images. And unfortunately, Apple hasn't given any indication recently about when or even if they will support WebP images. The reason I call out the lack of total browser support is not to deter you from using WebP images. Instead, I wanted to make sure you realize that it's not as simple as globally replacing all your images with WebP images. There are ways you can allow users that are using browsers that support WebP to take advantage of the benefits of WebP images, and at the same time still display images to Safari users. We'll go over how you can accomplish this when we talk about the practical steps of implementing WebP later in this video. The other thing you need to be aware of is that the support for WebP image format in graphical editing tools is not as widespread yet as traditional formats such as PNG and JPEGs. Support is growing, but has not reached total adoption like other formats. Again, don't let this stop you from taking advantage of WebP images. We'll cover a few ways of converting images to WebP coming up in this next section. So now let's talk about some practical advice on implementing WebP images. The first thing required to take advantage of WebP images is actually converting them to the WebP format. There are many options to convert your images. On one side of the spectrum, you can have the process of converting your images totally automated by adding the conversion of your images as a part of a build process or adding a plugin to your content management system that will convert them as your users upload the images. There are frameworks like Gatsby.js that already have this built into their framework, but if you're not using a platform or framework that supports WebP images yet, I'll include a link in the video description to the WebP project's official conversion utility and a few other links to some of the articles that might help you get started. It's beyond the scope of this video to talk about how to build this into your build process or create your own plugin, but I do want to cover two websites that are great options for smaller sites that are hosting their images statically. The first site is the Squoosh site. This is an open source project developed by Google Chrome Labs. This site allows you to upload an image and then it will convert it to another format, WebP being one of those formats. Let me show you an example of how it works. I'll choose an optimized PNG image that I'm using on my site and then choose WebP as the format. You'll see that it's reduced the size of my optimized PNG from 284K to about 67K. One nice feature is that it allows you to see the difference between the original and converted versions by dragging the slider back and forth. By default, it uses 75% as the quality setting. That is usually a good starting point, but you can adjust it up if you notice that 75% is removing too many details. Just to provide a better illustration of the slider, let me adjust this quality setting to about 50%. You'll see that even at 50%, it looks pretty good. But if you look closely, you'll notice that it's taking out probably a little more detail than we want at 50%, especially if you look around the edges of some of these objects. The next tool I want to show you is a tool I mentioned in my video on web performance tools. It's the Website Speed Test Image Analysis tool. This is a good tool to use if you have images on an existing site that you want to convert. You can simply enter the URL to the page you want to optimize, and the tool will analyze your page, give you a current optimization score, and then give you recommendations for each image on the format that would result in the most optimized image. In most cases, the recommended format will be WebP. You can then go to the See More section and click on the Download button to download the optimized image. So now let's talk about how to implement WebP images on your web page. In a perfect world, implementing WebP images would be no different than any other format. You would just refer to it in your image source attribute like normal. This works as suspected in most browsers. Unfortunately, like we mentioned earlier, there are browsers like IE11 and Safari that do not support WebP format. To support Safari and IE11, we can use the HTML5 picture element. To use the picture element, we include the picture opening and closing tag, and then include source elements for both a WebP version and a version like PNG or JPEG that is supported by the other browsers. We also include a traditional image tag for browsers that do not support multiple source elements. That's all you have to do to have cross-browser support for your inline images. Now about 78% of users are getting the benefits of faster webpage, and almost 100% of our users are still seeing the image, even if it is a little larger. But what about background images? Of course, you can't use a picture element for background images. There are several techniques available to provide fallback support to IE11 and Safari, but the one I find the easiest to use is a feature detection library called Modernizer. Modernizer is a JavaScript library that runs tests on page load to detect what browser features are available to the user. And then, based on the results, you can respond appropriately. Let's add Modernizer to our page, and we can use WebP images for our background images and have it fall back to a PNG for Safari and IE11. First, we'll go to Modernizer's site and go to the download section. One nice thing about Modernizer is that you can customize the JavaScript file to only include the features you care about, and so this helps keep the script file really small. We'll choose WebP and build our download. Then we'll download the file, include it in our project, and include a reference to the script file in our HTML file. We can then add two versions of our CSS class, one that refers to PNG files for the browsers that don't support WebP, and then another that uses our WebP file. If we inspect our source, we see that on page load, the Modernizer library is adding the appropriate class to our HTML tag based on whether it detected the WebP feature being supported by our current browser. In today's video, we learned about the benefits of WebP images. We also talked about some practical ways you can start implementing WebP images on your site. My hope is that I've given you the information needed to get started on focusing on web performance by starting with image optimization. If it's not feasible for you to convert the entire site, one thing you can do is focus on your more prominent content first. That way you can start getting the performance boost needed to get your content noticed. The question of the day is, what success have you had with the WebP format? Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like, and make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below, and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.